ili awaongeleshe. Karibu ndugu yangu.
Your Excellency, the Governor, Kisumu County, Prof. Anyang, Engineer Toro is with us. Karibuni sana, Ahero Nyando. Sitakuwa na wakati mrefu, Your Excellency, niko na timu yangu, ile tunafanya kazi na wao. Machiefs wasimame mali wako, wako huko ndani. Mheshimiwa, Your Excellency, hapa Nyando na kuhakikishia tunafanya kazi na county staff wako kabisa. Madam County Commissioner angekuwa hapa lakini kwa shughuli zingine ameomba ruhusa. Na akasema hivi. Kwanza niwaombe ruhusa kwa sababu ya maneno ya COVID tumefunja sheria leo na governor atatusamehe. Hiyo ni ya kwanza, ya pili Mheshimiwa governor wakati una unveil Ahero ikuwe town, tutajifunia maneno mengi. Land value itaenda juu, land rate itaenda juu, na mimi naomba ukipata wageni wengi kutoka Kisumu, uturudishie hapa Ahero ili tuenjoy matunda ya Ahero. Hiyo ni ombi langu, nitakuwa mzuri kama itakuwa Ahero town, kipindi chako kikwisha either 2045, itakuwa imekuwa city. Tusiwe na city moja Kisumu County. Tuwe na city mbili ama tatu. Na hiyo it will go to your legacy, your governor. Hapa mambo ya security na kuhakikishia iko sawa. Hatuna shida. Wakati tunafanya mambo yetu huwa tuna consult your staff. Hata ukiniona saa hii nakaa karibu na Oroni. Tuko pamoja na tunafanya kazi mzuri. Kwa hayo sitaki kuharibu wakati. Karibu ni Nyando, karibu Ahero, na jina Ahero, Kinjadue nasema napenda sana. Thank you very much.
Asante DCC, we were meant to have in our midst the CEO of the Council of Governors, the Honorable Jacqueline Mogeni, but she has sent a representative whom I would like now to call up front, Mr. Kaziti. Where are you? Please, Kizito, please.
Thank you, Deputy Governor. Your Excellency, the Governor. Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor. The Honorable Speaker. All dignitaries, the MCS. Na wananchi wa Ahero hamjambo. Mimi naitwa Kizito Wangalwa, Director kwa Council of Governors. And a former deputy governor in the Republic of Kenya. Na nimefurahi kuja hapa leo. I want to, on behalf of the staff of the council, nimetumwa hapa na Madam Jacqueline Mogeni, kurudisha asante sana kwa Mheshimiwa governor kwa uzinduzi wa town hii. Na hiyo ndio Kiswahili yangu itaishia hapo because I know upande huu either Kijaluo ama Kizungu, si ndio? So I'll read the speech of the CEO Council of Governors. Allow me from the onset to congratulate Your Excellency Professor Peter Anyang Nyong'o for unveiling not just Ahero Town but also Kisumu City and Maseno Town. So far in the whole Republic, this is the highest number of urban authorities that have been created in a single county. We now have 59 counties, 59 municipalities and urban areas that have been created in the whole Republic. We have walked this journey with Ahero Town through a program called Symbio City, which is funded by the Swedish government. And we are proud also, therefore, to be associated with this unveiling of this town today. As part of our urban development program as a country, we know that we have many challenges, and some of the challenges that still remain is the framework of urban financing that is still a challenge, not just because the counties don't want, but we know that as a country, we must prioritize. The needs of urban areas far supersede the budgets that counties are given. Kwa mwisho, mimi nataka tu tena kutuma pongezi kwa gavana wenu na county mzima kwa uzinduzi huu, and we will walk the journey of urban development together with the people of Kisumu. Hongera sana watu wa Kisumu.
Asante sana, the representative of Jacqueline Mogeni, who also happens to be a former deputy governor. Allow me at this point, Governor, to invite the chairman of the National Irrigation Authority, the Honorable Engineer Joshua Toro.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency, the Governor of Kisumu County, my good friend, Professor Nyong'o, Deputy Governor, Dr. Owiri, the County Speaker, Mr. Oraro, the Majority Leader of the County Assembly, and all your MCAs, the CECs of the county, invited guests, not to forget the County Commissioner's representative who has just talked here, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. God is good. Aye. God is good. Can I see? God is good. And all the time. Muriaga inyuothe. Muriaga rengi. Ona niye de mwega. Na rĩu ngwaria na gĩkũyũ. Tondũ rĩrĩ, ona arĩa moima haha rĩ, mekwaragia na kĩnjaruo, na niĩ njaria na kĩ? Na gĩkũyũ. Eni, you know, everybody who was here was short waving me, but I was hearing more often tano tena, tano tena. Na rĩu hau nĩho ndĩ ona niĩ. I happen to come from very, very far with my friend, the governor. We used to be in parliament as opposition members of parliament, seeking how to remove the Kano government led by Moi then. Then we came and formed the Naki government with the Kibaki, where we were ministers, where Nyong'o served as Minister for Planning and Minister for Health. And myself, I was in charge of roads with Baba. I was deputy to Raila. Sasa kona majina mingi, alianza tinga, kakuja right honorable Prime Minister, sasa ni Baba. Ni sawa? Si amegraduate, sasa ni Baba. Mlizikia hata His Excellency Uhuru kule akimuita Baba, wakati alikuwa hapa. Alikuwa hapa Jomo Kenyatta. Sialisema baba, tuko na baba hapa. Na hiyo ndio cheo ile kubwa sana mtu anaweza pewa ya baba. Si ni baba wa taifa. Asante. Now as exposed in the Vision 2030, our country aims to be a globally competitive and prosperous country with high quality of life by 2030. It aims to transform Kenya into a new industrializing middle-income country, providing a high quality of life to all its citizens in a clean and secure environment. As you are aware, the Constitution of Kenya 2010 brings on board devolution, which is very important to Kenyans, and creates counties and their respective county governments. The objects of devolution, among others, include to recognize the right of communities to manage their own affairs, like we are selling the community in Ahero and West Kano and rice growing areas, to make sure they manage their activities and make sure that rice growing is a profitable undertaking. To provide proximate, easily accessible service, decision and visit complementarity and supplementarity between the efforts of the national government and the county governments. The above considerations create a formidable ground as to why Ahero should be upgraded from a center to a town. This upgrading initiative could not have come at a better time than now. It will no doubt play a key role to accelerate development of the region and to improve on service delivery to the betterment of the well-being of the people of Ahero, Kisumu County, and Kenya at large. The National Irrigation Authority is pleased to be part of this historic moment in the unveiling of the Ahero as an irrigation-driven town. The enactment of the new Irrigation Act 2019 transitioned the former National Irrigation Board to National Irrigation Authority. The Act gives National Irrigation Authority mandate to develop and manage irrigation services beyond the originally gazetted public national schemes. Many of you might not know, these schemes by name are Ahero, where we are, West Kano, Bunyara, Pekera, Hora, Bura, and Moya. National Irrigation Authority's vision is to deliver water to every irrigable acre, while our mission is to provide and coordinate sustainable development and management of irrigation services in Kenya. Your Excellency, I'm pleased to announce that the reinvigorated National Irrigation Authority will stop at nothing until it exploits all the country's irrigation potential, estimated at about 1.9 million acres. 506,000 acres of this potential lie within the Lake Victoria Basin. And that is, working mathematically quickly, 25%. About 25% of the oil irrigation in Kenya is in this region, Kisumu County. Simujipigie makofi basi. The Lake Basin is thus both an area of great interest and focus to the National Irrigation Authority. In Kisumu County, the National Irrigation Authority has, over the last 3 years, a very short period, committed to over 550 million to expand the area under irrigation from an initial 8,000 acres to the current 13,000 acres. This expansion supports over 7,000 farmers directly and over 30,000 households indirectly, not to mention the business people who are trading with rice as a commodity. The developed irrigation area produces over 60,000 metric tons of rice per year, with a gross market value of Kenya shillings 2.8 billion in that 1 year. For the farmer, this translates to an income of approximately 300,000 Kenya shillings per acre per year. Going forward, National Irrigation Authority over the next 3 years will commit resources to expand irrigation area in Kisumu County by a further 5,500 acres. The proposed targeted areas include Awashi, Shiga, Abo, Boha, and Kovongo. Pardon my pronunciation, but I understand you get the meaning of that name. They should bring the total acreage to about 18,000 acres. That's in the next 3 years. Almost all this positive development, I also recognize that there is the challenge of rising lake levels and frequent flood and hailstorm damage. There is a time the governor came in to salvage the farmers when we had hailstorm, and he was kind enough to give us 13 million Kenya shillings, which went a long way in helping the farmers. Indeed, as I speak, I'm cognizant that the rising lake levels has consumed over 80% of irrigable land in West Kano irrigation scheme. I emphasize with our farmers in West Kano, whose means of livelihoods has been eroded, if not destroyed. My authority, in a bid to minimize the sufferings of the people of West Kano, has commissioned the construction of a borehole at a cost of 4.3 million. The borehole will supply the community with clean potable water for domestic use. I am elated to announce that the borehole will start functioning in a period of the next 2 weeks. We have combined efforts with our parent ministry to explore ways and means that will enable us to reclaim the scheme and normalize production and operation activities. I invite you, Your Excellency, and other stakeholders to join us in these efforts of seeking for a solution to the problem of West Kano. Notwithstanding the above challenges, it is evident that the nerve center for Ahero Town economic growth will rightfully anchor on the irrigation sector. The required catalysts include the need to pursue aggressive, prudent development, rehabilitation, expansion, utilization, operation, and management of irrigation infrastructure and facilities. Irrigation will offer opportunity to increase food production for food and nutritional security, to intensify and diversify agricultural production and the associated value chains, to create wealth and generate the much needed employment for men, women, and youth. Towards this desired development, Your Excellency, I invite your county government to work closely with the National Irrigation Authority to realize the dreams and aspirations of the rice-growing farmers, to holistically improve their livelihoods and increase their per capita income. In particular, the Kisumu County government should consider increasing support in the areas of farmers' capacity building, production, harvesting, processing, storage, value addition, and marketing. Your government will also need to create favorable and conducive environment through legal, policy, and administrative action for the private sector to play their meaningful role in the development of rice-growing areas. I have no doubt that the development of the irrigation and the related sectors through concerted and coordinated approach will serve as the required magic bullet to change the development and economic fortunes of Ahero Town and its people. As I close, let me thank you, Your Excellency, for your outstanding leadership and support for the major irrigation development projects in the county. As National Irrigation Authority, we will continue to foster and cement partnership with your government and any other stakeholder that will accelerate and sustain the development of Ahero Town. I wish to congratulate you and the people of Ahero for the successful launch of the Ahero Irrigation Town. The journey to a prosperous and spreaded Ahero town has just begun. Thank you and be blessed. Irokamano. Before I sit down, I have only one clarion call which I want to leave with you. As a politician, we work on clarion calls because that's what moves the people. The clarion call for BBI is reggae. Reggae cannot stop, eh? So we are going forward. Now, I'll tell you what to say. When I say Kisumu County, you say the rice county, the rice county. Meshika, Kisumu County, Kisumu County. I'll go a step further so that we finish. Anyang Nyong Tano Tena. Anyang Nyong. So can I start again? Kisumu County. Kisumu County. Anyang Nyong. Anyang Nyong. Thank you very much.
Nataka tupige makofi mgeni wetu wa Chelariade. Joaero. Joaero Nyando. Adwane wa pamne wenu kunge kumwae. The lake meets the mountain. Chelariade. Kendo. Thank you so much, engineer. Now, Ahero is a unique town. Ahero is unique in the sense that from three quarters of the Republic of Kenya, you cannot get into Kisumu before passing Ahero town. Secondly, Ahero has one of the most hardworking population that I know of in my life. Ningi saka na Ahero unge yueyo. Anan wonya kachko geru na dongo nyabondo kucho. Tonitie waya moro mokendi kabonyo kanyagwal. Toneo kadwa dili, menikat kani dili, meto unge yueyo. Emome yange, niji Ahero Nyando, nikachkoro miu town. This town will grow in leaps of bounds and bounds because the nature of the people who occupy the city are hardworking people. Maradek, any I have today seen your love for the governor of the county of Kisumu. Na sewache earlier on. Today, a Ahero multipurpose car, you have endorsed the governor for a second term and have agreed in one unison that governor will reign as the governor of the county of Kisumu until 2027. Mando Gadir, Tadwana watch nu kama naibu governor, kakaja loop governor, abi kuende mangen, kenda chiko yita enya. Neket ka chiko yita kawinje watch maro, tanya alome yangoa, anya lo sume par. Kamora mora masedie. Eidala manya kachkogero, giwachone anyang tano tena. Eidala mamuroni. Giwacho ni anyang tano tena. Kawuone dala mar Nyando, anyang tano tena. E dala mar Kisumu East, anyang tano tena. E dala mar Kisumu Central, anyang tano tena. Kisumu West, anyang tano tena. Dala mar Seme, angeni wangake Jacob mar party ochar, giwacho ni anyang up to 2037. Omiyo, Professor Osiru endorsement from all the voting blocks in the county of Kisumu. Ngamadwa edo rendu achu, mano wachi karanga duyo lawi midi lale na mataro mano wachi. Adui biro lawi, wanu wange ni next time ngamachungi governor onge, governor binya lodia, odhiyo konyo waga kinyi, mono manyi pinyi. Nekat pin maduong mwaduwaro mamalo cha pokji watu wanaade, pokji watu wanaade. Atiko kawacho kama, melimoro nyocho uok Nairobi, orao kisi kacha, bang'e ochopo namar Victoria. To wawuoro ni meli maduong' ni dhi kanye to ting'o ng'a gini. Wawuok gi speaker, wawuok gi Anyang, wawuok gi majority leader, jo Kisumu mang'eny. Wadhi ng'iyo gima meli obiro timo ng'owa e dala mar Kisumu. Kwang'iyo kama, to waneno ka meli ni riembo kod Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta to gi Raila Amolo Odinga. To ng'eye gi kacha, waneno min Mary kochung' Anyang Obwango Wuonyalung'a. To gwela to ng'ise ne ojakogero. Luonguru ji odonje meli. Mae meli mwadhi godo Kanan. Mae meli mwadhi godo kanye, Kanan. To meli no en meli mar BBI. To mina kinyi wacho, no wacho Kisumo kacha. No ng'eyo ni koro sani nikech sa ochopo ma joka nyanam dhi Kanan. Nitie andhoke moko madhi biro. Ni koro kidwa donje meli, kadu ilungi donje meli, elicho luongi donje meli, owili luongi donje meli, madanje wachi donje meli. To ng'ato wacho ni awe donje meli, ogweli ni ibi ka wheelbarrow. Ochako gweli ni ibi ka ndiga. Ochako gweli ni obi ka mkokoteni. Ado anapenju gimoro joka nyanam. Uwinja, apenju ni kama meli kalo na mataro ma meli kalo ndiga nyalo kalo. Na mataro ma meli kalo pikipiki nyalo kalo. Omiyo unduto te, udonje meli kanye magavana nitie. Unduto te, udonje meli mar BBI kanye mababa nitie. Unduto te, udonje meli mano e kama president mar piny Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta nitie. Ereji ya dimo yye donje meli, tina uru badu malo kama. Koro chopo sama koro. Ochopo sama koro. Omin meri koro duwa mondo bimondo weo woko, duwa mondo unveil the town. Toka poko timo kama ano.
Kwa kwa kikoni, kwa kama, kwa kama ude. Mbani kuza. Eke kama ude, kwa kama ude. Mbani kuza. Maktau kwa kama. Ngato watu ni town, inuwa look town. Kumpuza poko konsolta. Nigu wabidu town. Kesa o, pesna giri kuzu. Kena giri kuzu. Ha? Nyakati. Nyakati. Wesie mae mbele umati watu. Ma, niti, ulitoka na hati. Gwe. Ha? Ha? Tobaki ni bimbele. Ha?
Mbele ajisi ni kawe mbunu 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 mbunu
mbunu mbunu mbunu mbunu
mbunu
mbunu mbunu mbunu mbunu
mbunu mbunu mbunu mbunu mbunu mbunu.
Ateji, ojol, asalani, kwa tumoro na kofemu. Emomi ovi, iwi njo. Kamanyaka na chakle riki ni redio kini nyaka sama kamaya. Ne hukari. Wajma tao meni wajma peri muki. Maya chiri kumolembe magde vishu. Makoro jombincha kone. Maya chiri kumik mariki morobo wajuni. Anshe chayenlik na ipirinu hao. Nyoro ni bili ofisa sarani. Ki watu ni ngato ogedo mudo ni na kilo pia ichuni chiyo.
Kuru ngini biru tawaka. Yune kini okubiru wawu yoma kia kure. Mano neko kia kure. Kuru mawa neka sibeka. Ha? To wano to wano kwa kani. Nika niwa mwonge de kwa. Mwone kwa.
Nyakate. Katatuk manatuku kuru. Kingdom mau tuh dia apa? Ayun mana dah sejam, ayun mana dah sejam. Dombe, babu tu tu, you are ansa, you kena tu. Iu injo, sama dongrok, biru gigit pokok lucu mabeh. Makata bapa mau kemai jolly, muda hanya dima, iu ma iu sibuka. Kuri bedok kami mau ni dignitaris, emanya lo singatam. You enjoy it, eh? Wechi magban, koro ka uchumi makar ka gerole, purtini mi mabe, bang pedo mane ya ero ka ingi. Eh? Taebilo liye nyake buki kandani, you enjoy it. Purtini ya, maano kore ka mi biro chielo, mi biro gero mabe mali.
They ok digo ipin kendo deri bro losi. Wene monda nyisu niya, governor nitiere majipato, wane modhi ruake, kisironyo, ginyasi, tomiwa weche mamit, madongo, matao. Ha? Iu! Nakate! Ha?
Sanchez.
Haya. Tumpige makofi. Asante sana. She has reminded us about what we must do as a people to keep corona or COVID-19 at bay. It is now my humble duty, ladies and gentlemen, to invite the governor, Adwan Waruto Achung, Mondo Waruak governor, Mark County, Makisumo, Owo Kodwa, Kendo Mondo Koro Yao, town ni officially. Karibu, Governor. Hi.
Asanteni sana, wananchi watukufu.
Leo ni leo. Leo ni nini? Leo ni nini? Asemaye kesho ni nani? Basi, yokanya na mutie. Umor. Aya Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. Siku leo ni siku kuu, tena ni siku muhimu sana. Kwa sababu tuko hapa watu wengi sana kutoka Kisumu County kote ili tukaribisha mji wetu ya Ahero. Waruake. Waruake. Ah, ladies and gentlemen, to begin with, let me begin by welcoming many friends who have come here today to join us on this great day. My Deputy Governor Matthew Owili was just welcomed me here. The County Commissioner, Madam Josephine Ouko, represented by Deputy County Commissioner here, the Chairman of the National Irrigation Authority, Engineer Joshua Toro, with whom I shared many good times in the National Assembly and in the NAC government and the coalition government. Representing the CEO Council of Governors, Mr. Kizito, thank you very much for representing Madam Jacqueline Mogeni with a very, very encouraging message to us today. And all those of you who are here, Engineer Jack Uraro and the MCS wote ambao wako hapa leo, waziri katika serikali ya gatuzi ya Kisumu ambao wako hapa leo pia, na viongozi wote, my elders kutoka Ahero na Nyando kwa jumla. Asanteni sana kuja hapa leo ili tukaribishe mji yetu ya Ahero. I'm pleased, ladies and gentlemen, to join you here today to witness this historic occasion unfolding by the shores of our great river Nyando. It is a beautiful day, as you can see, more beautiful than ever before. The weather is cool and warm at the same time, the river is calm. When I listen around, I hear nothing but excitement because a child has been born, like Jesus was born in the town of Nazareth. I want to sincerely thank the leaders in Nyando sub-county for sparing their time to attend this function today. I also salute the traders, the mama mbogas in this town and the market, the entire business community in Ahero for supporting the initiative that my government has taken to upgrade Ahero to a town. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here to declare Kirasmi a fully fledged town, complete with all instruments of power and befits its new status. From today, it shall no longer be Ahero Market, it shall be Ahero Town. Makofi. Ningependa kualika hapa the interim town administrator, Mr. Mimo, aje hapa leo, mjua ya kwamba huyu sasa ni mkuu wa town ya Ahero, Bwana Mimo. So he will be having an office here. We have inaugurated the office. Asante sana ndugu. Ahero is a landmark town with interesting features and a blooming economy. It's a farming town surrounded by lush green rice fields and the great Nyando agricultural belt teeming with sugarcane plantations. Ahero town sits on the major highways to Nairobi, Hispania, Nyamira, Kisii, and Homa Bay. It also has all that a town needs: a sub-county hospital, a court, a police station, schools, a market, and other social amenities. And I assure you, as it becomes a town, we shall add more social amenities to this town. We shall add more social amenities to this town and improvement tremendously in terms of economic development, as well as housing. Ladies and gentlemen, Ahero becomes the second town we are unveiling after Maseno. We had earmarked 5 urban centers to be upgraded as towns. Others in the queue are Muhoroni, Katito, Kombewa. But while we are upgrading these centers into towns, urbanization, as you know, ladies and gentlemen, is here with us, and we have to embrace it wholeheartedly. 2 days ago on Saturday, Kenya co-hosted with the World Cities Day, during which delegates acknowledged the need for building resilient cities and towns as drivers in achieving sustainable development goals. We know for certain, by the year 2050, half of Africa's population will be living in urban areas. We must therefore begin by expanding our facilities in urban areas and making them places to feel at home. In his speech, the UN Habitat Executive Director said, and I quote, "The new urban agenda makes the case for the value of sustainable urbanization, or how people are choosing to make their lives in cities and towns, and how this can contribute to economic prosperity, environmental equality, social equity, and strengthened civic and cultural institutions." On a global scale, ladies and gentlemen, over 55% of the population now live in urban centers, and this is projected to reach about 70% by the year 2050. The rural-urban migration is worrying, and the faster we prepare for this, the better. But it also tells us that we must improve economic development in rural areas. And that is why today we combined a project at the rice scheme in the town as well. My friend Toro has come because we know without improving rice production, rice milling, and putting more money to the farmers' buckets, they will not invest in Ahero town. If the farmers of Ahero, if the farmers of Nyando, who will build houses here, they're the ones who would buy commodities from here. They're the ones who will use the roads from here when they come in the evening to enjoy themselves. And therefore, the economy of the rural area of this area is symbiotically joined to Ahero, the growth of Ahero town. As an African country, these statistics are particularly important to us because apart from Asia, the urbanization will be happening in Africa much faster than anywhere else. According to the World Bank and the 2019 Kenya Population and Housing Census, the annual urbanization rate is estimated at 4%. Ladies and gentlemen, today we witness the birth and indeed growth of another iconic urban center, which is the undisputed gateway to the great city of Kisumu, as many people have said here today. Ahero must shine, because if it doesn't, Kisumu County may not live to current splendid ranking as a top performer and a top achiever. Allow me at this juncture to point out a few benefits that comes with Ahero's new status. First, Ahero, alongside other towns, will have to receive a dedicated budget to address its infrastructural issues, among other things, roads, drainage, street lighting, solid waste management system, among others. Therefore, as somebody said here earlier, when we get resources from the national government to improve our cities and urban centers, we are not in any way apologizing for that. We are taxpayers like other Kenyans. We deserve the best from the Kenyan government, and therefore, as the governor of the great county of Kisumu, I will not apologize to anybody for getting resources from the national government to develop our county. Because after all, the Kenyan people live in counties. They don't live in heaven. And therefore, we must develop our counties and our cities the best way we can, with our resources, with resources from the national government, and with resources from development partners. I am committed to this. I will work for it, and you will get the benefit. Ahero, alongside other towns, will have to receive a dedicated budget to address its problems, as I have said. To bring this closer home, ladies and gentlemen, my government in this year's budget has earmarked about 400 meters of road network within Ahero town for upgrading to paving block standard alongside drainage improvement works. Mount 35 streetlights along streetlights of Ahero stretching over a kilometer. Similarly, we are putting up a circular solid waste management
which involve composting of organics into fertilizer, recover and recycle plastics and glass into building blocks. A town status to Ahero town will put it at a position to compete for various urban financing, specifically targeting for towns, municipalities, and cities. We have mentioned here before a program like Kenya Urban Support Program. Up to now, that program has been covering mainly Kisumu. Now that Ahero and Maseno are towns, it will be extended to the two towns. This will help the town realize even much faster urban infrastructural development. You will remember that when President Uhuru Kenyatta went to France recently, he came back with a present to Kisumu County with funds from the Agence Française de Développement to give Maseno, Ahero, and Kisumu money to develop its water and drainage resources. And therefore, this is one of the benefits that comes around when markets are upgraded to urban centers. Ahero Town will have a dedicated governance system made of a town management committee and a town administrator who will look into the day-to-day activities of the town as per the provisions of the Urban Areas and Cities Act. The town administrator will lead a dedicated staff made up of a town planner, a town engineer, a town public health officer, among others, staff relevant for town administration. Issues of Ahero Town will therefore be addressed much faster than they are currently. The expansion of the Ahero Irrigation Scheme by the national government through the National Irrigation Authority will only add to the fortunes of Ahero. And I want to announce here, as I was sitting with my colleagues from Parliament in near Toro, we agreed with him that an extra mill will be placed at the irrigation board that will be able to mill our Sindano rice here and not take it to Uganda when it is not yet milled. That will allow our farmers to get more money, and the Sindano rice will be able to enter our supermarkets as Ahero rice. Makofi. With an integrated urban strategic development plan, which is nearing completion, and subsequent town boundary delineation, Ahero town growth will be controlled within a restricted spatial boundary. This will particularly ensure that the rich agricultural land in the larger Kano Plains, which has been the single most contributing factor for the growth of the town, is protected. The same applies to the Nyong'o riparian ecosystem. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish to inform you that Ahero town is starting on a promising note because it's already a beneficiary of Swedish-funded project town as a symbiocity. The symbiocity project aims at improving the status of the town on urban planning and improvement of infrastructure. If you don't plan, you can't prepare for the future. To plan is to choose. We must choose to go forward. Kisumu was one of the 18 counties picked for the project, and we settled on Ahero. The aim was to make Ahero a clean, healthy, resilient, and convergent town for prosperity. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, the growth of these satellite towns will not only bring services closer to the people, but also create economic nodes that will create opportunities for thousands of people. This will also serve to reduce the pressure on the city of Kisumu. I am looking forward with excitement to the completion of the confinement exercise to the other four remaining towns of Muroni, Kombewa, and Katito, which have all been gazetted. We shall continue monitoring the growth of our urban centers and make appropriate plans for them so as to ensure that we harness the full potential of urbanization. I wish to assure the people of this great county of Kisumu that we are on the right path in delivering all the promises we made in our manifesto. Today, as part of our COVID-19 economic recovery program, we have commissioned at the irrigation scheme, fruit seedlings, vegetable seeds, cereals, irrigation equipment, and one-day-old chicks worth 13 million shillings to 10,000 smallholder farmers in Kisumu County. This is in line with our policy of reinforcing the household economy. Reinforcing the household economy because we realized during COVID, it was the household which was the center of salvation for the people of Kisumu in producing food. The above items are input from the Kisumu County COVID-19 funds, the National Irrigation Authority, and the national government. In details, we'll be giving out 5,000 one-day-old chicks valued at 1 million shillings to 25 groups in Muroni, Nyando, Nyakach, and Seme sub-counties. We have purchased vegetable and cereal seeds worth 5.5 million shillings, which is enough to plant 2,200 acres of kitchen gardens by 10,000 households in the 7 sub-counties. In addition, we have purchased 3,600 meters of irrigation pipes to enhance horticultural production of 100 acres at Miguye in Kobura Ward. The national government has also given us 20.8 metric tons of rice seeds valued at 4.8 million shillings that can plant 2,600 acres of farms today. Further, ladies and gentlemen, we have also received 10,000 grafted mangoes and avocado seedlings worth 3 million shillings to be distributed to 1,000 farmers in Seme, Kisumu, Moroni, and Nyakach. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, I want to make a passionate appeal to all of you to help us in the fight against COVID-19. The virus has spiked out of control and is killing many people. No one is safe. No one is safe. The fight against COVID-19 now rests with you as an individual. Madam County Commissioner and myself have issued past warnings to remind you to adhere to the public health guidelines, but many people still disregard them. Let me assure you that we are going to take very tough steps to make sure that we adhere to these good guidelines because they are good for saving our lives. Let me remind you today that don't crowd in funerals. Bodies must be buried on the same day upon a removal from the mortuaries. Stop eating at funerals, wear a mask all the time, and seek medication if you suspect you are sick. Together, we will kick COVID-19 out of Kisumu. With those remarks, ladies and gentlemen, I want to assure you that with God's blessing and support, looking after us, we shall defeat COVID and build Ahero as a healthy, prosperous, and town that in which we can feel at home. Koro wawachi gidoluo matinjo kanyana. Mokamano. Kane wachako, mama moro no biro ka. Mopenjo wa, ni wanyalo konyo wakina mama nadi. Togi wakina youth. Ere kaka genyalo timo hala. Koko wayudo nigigi moro matin. Adwa nyiso wakina mama nagi youth yote, tega masikio tafadhali. One kaka jo county makisumo kwa sete rowachi assembly nyocho wase winjireni igani wakete budget makisumo million pirayoga uchiel mwabiro konyo gomine giyudhe mono giloko hala kamano omenontie utaratibu. Nitie utaratibu manyaka luu kidwa yudo pesa ni. Nikech maineno yuagre malicha inyaka yudhe bo yuagre. Pesa nitie budget mabiro konyo mine gi yudhe kumloko wala. Waiego, toda kupam na muli ngalingani. Mara rio, adu wawacho kama gido luo. Gimuatimo kaka uono, nuwa kao town, chiro mara hero waketo town. En gima biro konyo jopiny nikech wakete kata town kamano gi nyinge wadwa keto town gi team omiyo yori biro loso wabiro loso teini drainage biro loso to facilities be nyaka bedie mitimo go ohala omiyo nyaka ng'e ni gimwatimo kawuono en gima muhimu okodwanwa lost town kende wadwani pur mar niang to gar mchele godhi nyime emumneno neno kaeri kaja kom ma national irrigation authority midusa toro obiro kaka wuono kaka engineer kaka jakom mondo wati kara achiel wan ka giwuoy motegna dinga ni tanui ene motel ni irrigation iga mokado cha kana jopur peyogo ogo mchele no wabiro mwa winjre mwa mio jopur milioni 13 mondo pur jopuro puro maber kabisa mawangi mchele onyak okaka mang'eny kabisa to kwadwa ni mchele ni odi Uganda wadwa no rege kaeri e machine mwan woka omwe wase winjre gi injinia toro ni machiegni wabiro keto milka within a matter of 2 or 3 weeks 1 month mondo milo berka milege mchele.